In this video, you will learn 6 tips that will help you to stop overanalyzing and obsessing over a man. And better yet, engaging in these psychologically based tips will also make your relationship happier and make you more attractive to your man. Sound too good to be true? Trust me, these tips are powerful. They work well and anyone can do them. So don't go anywhere because we're starting right now. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Antonio Borrello and I'm a psychologist and a relationship coach. This channel is all about helping you build great relationships so you can grow happy with the people you love. So if you're interested in making your love life the best part of your life, start now by clicking the subscribe button and hit the bell notification so you aren't missing anything. Okay, how to stop overthinking and obsessing and get all of the attention you want from him. If you've ever been in a relationship or dated someone that you really liked, chances are you felt insecure or jealous or anxious about it at some point or another. And having those thoughts is perfectly normal and even expected in a new relationship. However, if you find that you are frequently overthinking and worrying that he's not into you or that something is wrong, then you know it's incredibly stressful. But what's even worse, obsessing and overthinking things can cause you to engage in needy and insecure behaviors that sabotage your relationship and cause the very things that you're most afraid of. The good news, I'm going to share some great strategies for turning things around so you can enjoy the amazing relationship you deserve. But first, ask yourself the following questions. Number one, do you find yourself frequently worrying about how he feels about you? Do you overanalyze his every action to see if he's reacting positively or negatively towards you? Do you find the need to repeatedly ask him how he feels so you can feel reassured? Have you felt the need to dig through his social media accounts or his call logs or his text messages? Do you worry that he doesn't love you as much as you love him? Do you worry that he might find someone else more attractive or worry that he might cheat on you? Have any of these worries caused you to have disagreements or arguments or fights with him? Again, it's normal to have some of these thoughts, especially in the beginning of new relationships. But if you are worrying about more than 2 of these things and find it stressing you out, then you need to get your anxiety under control before you ruin any chances of your relationship working out. So, without further ado, here are the 6 tips that you've been waiting for. Number 1, make your anxiety work for you. Constantly worrying and obsessing over someone or something happens when you want to control an outcome, yet you're in a position with little or no power to do anything. For example, you are texting and calling your boyfriend, but he's not responding. And that leaves you feeling insecure and scrambling for some solutions or to gain back some control. And then your obsession with the situation causes you to engage in compulsive behaviors over and over again, hoping for an answer. For example, you call and text over and over again, hoping that this will cause him to respond. But instead of gaining control over the situation, continuing to call or text him makes you increasingly more anxious and insecure. It's like a vicious circle. And that makes you appear out of control and needy and desperate. And when you do that, you inevitably push him out of your life. So instead, I want you to use your anxiety as motivation to make positive changes that will make you more attractive. Changes that will make him want you more. Think about it. Fear is a powerful motivator. So make it work for you. When you feel an episode coming on, when you start to feel anxious about something in your relationship, when you feel like you are obsessing and need to communicate with him, you need to stop yourself and recognize that you are obsessing and then engage in the following steps. Number 2, set a freakout deadline. What I really want to say here is don't act on your impulses no matter how anxious you get, but that's easier said than done. Telling yourself not to act on your impulses might work for some people, but I have found that setting a freakout deadline is a great strategy as well. So, when you are confronted by a situation or something seems to be going wrong, rather than reflexively panicking and following your old script, set a deadline for when you will allow yourself to deal with it. For example, let's say that you've texted your boyfriend and it's been a few hours, but he still hasn't responded to you. Instead of panicking, tell yourself that you will be fine with things for the time being, and if nothing changes by tomorrow, then you can deal with it. If you make that deal with yourself, you will often find that the situation resolves itself without having to do anything further. And you also avoid engaging in needy behaviors that you will later regret. Now, the next 4 tips consist of simple behavioral changes that will help you to keep your anxiety and overthinking under control. That's because engaging in these 4 habits will help to keep your brain chemistry balanced and help you achieve a healthier and happier state of mind. These tips also reduce the negative effects of stress by making you more resilient and keeping those negative emotions at bay. And when those things happen, you are happier, feel more in control and optimistic, and more satisfied with your life. And these are things that make you more attractive as well. Number three, practice meditation. As I'm sure you're aware, mindfulness meditation has caught on in a big way over the past few years, and for good reason. If practiced correctly, mindfulness meditations can help improve health, mood, brain power, sleep habits, dietary habits, and your sex life. Meditation is a precise technique for resting the mind and attaining a state of consciousness that is totally different from the normal waking state. In meditation, the mind is clear, relaxed, and inwardly focused. When you meditate, you are fully awake and alert, but your mind is not focused on the external world or on the events taking place around you. Meditation requires an inner state that is still and one-pointed so that the mind becomes silent. And when the mind is silent and no longer distracts you, meditation deepens. Learning to meditate is like learning any other skill. It's like exercising a muscle that you've never really worked out before. It takes consistent practice to get comfortable, but the benefits are life-changing. I promise, when you practice daily, your life changes for the better. So, how do you start? Well, you can download apps that will teach you how to meditate, or you can purchase various meditation devices that provide real-time feedback on how you're doing. Number four. Take omega-3 supplements. You've probably seen omega-3 fatty acid supplements around your local health food store and on the internet. Basically, I'm talking about fish oil supplements. But what does fish oil have to do with anxiety? Well, according to so many studies, omega-3 fatty acids help to lower inflammation in your body, and it can also change the way your brain functions. Omega-3 fatty acids are a group of essential fatty acids that are vital for healthy brain function. But in particular, omega-3 fatty acids with the right concentrations of EPA and DHA help serotonin and dopamine circuits in our brains function more efficiently. And as you probably know, serotonin and dopamine are two neurotransmitters that regulate your mood and are responsible for happiness and pleasure. When you don't take in enough omega-3 fatty acids, either in your diet or with supplements, the circuitry for those two neurotransmitters doesn't function as efficiently. So you are less likely to feel happiness or pleasure. Unfortunately, most of us have a diet very low in this essential nutrient. But the good news is that it's easy to find as a supplement. So look for fish oil supplements that provide a daily dose of 1,000 milligrams of EPA and 500 milligrams of DHA for enhancing a positive mood. I use these every day, and I certainly notice a difference if I don't take them for a few days. They work, and there are tons of scientific studies that testify to its mood-enhancing benefits. Number five, exercise. Maintaining a healthy body not only helps keep you looking good, but also acts as a mood lifter and a source of increased energy. Several studies have found that exercise is about as effective, if not more effective, than most antidepressant medications. So when it comes to experiencing increased happiness, exercise makes a big difference. The best type of exercise that raises your level of happiness is an aerobic exercise that elevates your heart rate to about 140 to 160 beats per minute for 35 to 40 minutes at least three times each week. Types of aerobic exercise include walking, ideally at a brisk pace to achieve a moderate level of physical activity, jogging and running, as well as swimming and bicycling. Again, you've got to get your heart rate up to at least 140 and keep that pace for 35 minutes, three times a week. Number six, exposure to sunlight. Light exposure is something that many of us don't think much about, but it has a much more important role in keeping you happy than you think. Due to our long ancestral history of spending all day outside, our brains have developed a rhythm that depends on the bright light of the sun. When we spend all day in a room, even if it's brightly lit, we don't get enough light for the needs of our brain. Spending at least 30 minutes a day exposed to bright light, preferably at the same time every day, is essential to your well-being. This strategy is simple and easy to implement, and it can have quite the impact on decreasing symptoms of depression and anxiety. Now, for a cost-effective method, simply go outside to soak up the sun for 30 minutes or longer every day. But if you live in a cold climate, or if you're getting outside can be challenging for you, there are also light box options which emit 10,000 lux. This is your own personal sunshine to enjoy at home. Be sure to make the effort to get exposed to light every single day to reap the most benefits from this simple mood-boosting strategy. Now, do these lifestyle changes work? Yes, they work, and they work very well. They work individually, but they work best when you combine them all. Implementing these strategies not only makes you less anxious, They make you happier, more attractive, and healthier both physically and emotionally. It's your opportunity to become your best self. So give it a try and let me know how it works. I do all of these things and more, and I promise you that they work. Look, relationship anxiety is love's kryptonite. When it enters your relationship, you suffer with debilitating worry while your partner feels as if you're suffocating them. And anxiety makes it hard to realize what's important and what's not. It blows things out of proportion, it distracts you, and it cripples you. But it doesn't have to control you. It's not always easy to overcome, but it's possible and you can do it. You deserve to be in a happy, loving relationship that isn't marred by anxiety's vicious grip. All it takes is conscious effort and a new perspective to realize that anxiety's weakness is a loving connection. By strengthening your relationship, you weaken anxiety's grasp. And then you both win. Now, if you're interested in learning more about relationship anxiety, click here to check out this video, or click here to watch the video that YouTube thinks that you'll like. And please subscribe to get more videos that will help you build great relationships so you can grow happy with the people you love. I'll see you in the next video.